G'day all, Mr. Paladin here.
And good day all, Omegabot here.
And today we're on vlog number 7, and I thought it'd be fun as we look through these digital artworks that's from the discussion page, if I don't have Omegabot come along and see what he thinks about them too. What do you reckon?
I can go for some fan art right now.
Yeah, fan art and fun, just fun commentary. So let's see. First of all, I've got Creep across the street, and he's done a picture where it looks like I guess I'm with his scout, but we're getting chased by pyros, and we are just on the run. The sound of terror. Actually, it looks like there's even more pyros there than I thought. I just thought there were the two behind me, but I see behind the flames.
Yeah, I count three.
I count four. Look at that. There's one in behind his right leg and his left leg. You see the ones behind the scout? I mean, I'd be scared too. That's a lot of pyro. Now, I find a scout can be scared of pyros too, because like scouts can avoid a lot of damage, but you can't avoid the damage when it's actually on you and burning.
Fire, fire, fire. Ah, the fire.
More fire than, you know, Donald Trump trying to find a new apprentice. Okay, this next one here is by Lumi. Lumi is... I don't know if Lumi's actually the medic or if he's just got a stylized medic there, but it looks like I'm doing a trick stab on that.
And it looks like I'll find myself in the position of the medic on this picture.
You find you're the medic more often than the spy in this one?
Yep.
I kind of like this whole ambidexterity I've got going on, holding the ambassador and the knife. I like the glint off of the knife. Actually, I like the whole lighting in this. It's got the, like, dust particle effects going on.
Yeah, this is kind of... That's actually kind of good. Real nice.
Mm-hmm. It's styled. I'd like it. Oh, this is an all-common situation. This is from Meep, and this is Mr. Paladin Nightmares. You know, I'll put out a video saying, you know, you shouldn't use the Bombonomicon with the Dead Ringer, and what do you know, next game I'm in, it's like this.
Oh, dear goodness.
He's even finished
the gibbous.
Yeah, he's even finished it off with the gibbouses and the pyrovision goggles, just for the full effect of that Dead Ringer Bombonomicon.
No, get those stupid spies out of here.
But not necessarily all of these are like newbie spies. What's to say there's not one amongst those guys that's actually an experienced spy? You know, I like to go undercover too. I'll throw on my achievement items and just make it look like I'm inexperienced, because it'll fool some players.
True. Though just the sight is horrifying to
him. It's horrifying. Not nearly as horrifying as all those pyros in the other one.
Oh, dear goodness.
Oh, this, I love this one. This was a special request I did from Bob the Turtle. I had the idea, hey, Bob, could you do a game of like TF2 where we're all playing D&D and like make the barbarian be the heavy and like have a scout with a wizard hat on and a son of a stick as a wand? And I think it's perfect. Like, he's even got the guy we're fighting is a pyro with a dragon mask on, dinosaur mask.
I'm just starstruck at this. Oh, they made the little playable characters like wooden mannequins.
Yep, the little wooden mannequins. He's got the dice, but if you look at the titles of the book in the background. It says AG&G, and it's a player's guide. I don't know where he got the models for all this, but it's spot on. This was...
I'm pretty sure the player manuals were from the Happy Goblin... Happy Gargoyle thing?
Happy Gargoyle? Maybe so. I don't know, but he's really good. I had this as a special request, and he even put, like, candy on the table. Like, that's D&D players through and through. Okay, this one by Curry, and it's Mr. P and Curry. And he said he particularly liked what the medic was doing in the background.
Again, this is another one of those pictures that I find myself as the victim.
I just like the false perspective where you actually, you know, you've got the look of the victim, right? And you've got the two guns just pointed straight at you. You know you're in trouble.
Bang, bang.
It's like, go ahead, make our day. Oh, I love this one. Ye Old Switchy, right? He's even signed it at the bottom there. Did, like, Mr. Paladin and Dane collaboration. I'd love to do this. I keep saying that me and Dane have to do a video sometime. We have already done, like, that Wave 666 MVM game. But, you know, our times just don't seem to sync up. So we'll see if we can get something. But I'd love to do something where we're on the same team. People always portray us, though, as always being on the enemy team. I guess Dane's usually always red on defense and I'm always blue. What's with that?
I have no clue. Maybe it's just the natural rivalry of the universe.
Mm-hmm.
Spy always versus the NG.
Yep, it's our mutual enemies.
Also, when I first look at this image, I thought the Sahara spy thing... I thought, like, in the bottom left corner, you were putting the Sahara spy layout.
Oh, okay.
On, like, a cone of some sort.
Oh, yeah, it looks like, instead of the engineer's glove, it looks like a safety cone.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking, but then after seeing it up close,
like
I was all
a
like...
A safety clone with a Christmas hat wearing some glasses.
Yeah, but then when I look at it up close, it's Uncle Dan's arm.
But I love it when people do art like the cartoony type things. I absolutely enjoy that to no end. Okay, with Shia, Surprise did something called Relax, where it looks like... What in the world? Have I double-crossed my own team? Everyone on here is red.
Oh, dear. Oh, no.
I never really was on your side.
Oh, no. Stay back from me. Stay back. Stay back. Back, I say.
Omegabot, I am not your father.
Ah!
Time for a backstab. Actually, there's a lot of parental killing in the whole Star Wars series, isn't there?
Yeah.
Everyone's killing family members.
Scorched parents.
I'm saying.
Parents, robo-daddy.
Okay, Toronto, ooh, how do you pronounce that? Toronto? Yes, I guess it's Toronto. Did something called, I guess it's called a standoff. I actually like this, because, like, neither of us are gonna kill each other with those weapons. But it's like, so we're facing each other down in like a good, the bad, and the ugly kind of way. It's a standoff.
If that was a show reference, I do not know the show reference.
Oh, you know the old whistle. It's like... Wow, wow, wow.
Oh, yeah, I know the song, but if you were trying...
Well, that's what happens in the movie. They get three people, the good guy, the bad guy, and I guess the ugly guy. And they're all just pointing guns at each other, and it's a standoff. Nobody's really making the first move.
Huh.
See, there you go. We're going to have to watch that movie sometime or something. Put it on the list. Zeus has done one where we're together and we're back-to-back, two spies.
Hmm. I actually have no idea how to add on to this. This just looks amazing.
I like it. I like how you've got the ammo coming out of the gun, the shots coming out of the gun.
Yeah, a little...
I also like it... I've said before that you shouldn't overstack spy, but I really don't mind if there's another good spy on the same team as you and you just play off of each other. It's always a good time. You know, with 12 players on a team, sometimes you do get double spies. Hopefully not too many more than that. Juno has a really classy picture here with the spy carooning.
It looks like one of those old-timey movie... CD things.
Yeah, like a noir film or an old detective film or something like that. It was a dark and stormy night, and Mr. Paladin just decided to sing.
In the rain of his own hat.
Omegabot, how is my singing? Is my singing good? Could I match the spy?
I put it at 6.5.
You can actually hear the hesitation in Omegabot's voice. It's like, I don't really want to offend my dad, but my dad's voice is terrible. Kang Fu has a picture here. I've just called it a pose, but it's really, really good. The lighting on it is really great.
Looks like you're kind of preparing to jump out in front of a sentry gun, dead ringer it, get behind it, sap it.
Yeah,
exactly.
You can imagine the scene I'm looking at. I'm probably looking around the corner seeing five enemies, and let's see, okay, my first move is to headshot the engineer and then to sap his sentry gun, then onto the medic before his pocket realizes what is happening. And I've got to do this before the cigarette burns out. Actually, I do like that. He's actually got the lighting on the cigarette too,
yeah.
So it's got a little bit of effect. That's a really good consideration. I like it when people do that. Nice pose. I like it. Vidas? Ooh, I'm not sure how to pronounce this name either. Has one that I guess he calls You're Next. It's like I'm taking care of someone and then I'm looking down the stairs and I've already got my eyes on someone. I'm staring.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've already got the initial feeling of the You're Next kind of deal.
Mm-hmm. You're feeling that? What am I going to do from here? Am I whipping out the ambassador for a headshot? Am I going for a stair stab on you because you're still coming forward? What is it?
Oh, dear. I'm pretty sure I would hit my suicide bang.
Suicide? Just kill self. Let's see. AJ. AJ's done a couple of pictures for me. This one is called... I called it YouTuber Party because I see a couple of other YouTubers in the background there. I see a Ray. I see... it's Raj up there, and it looks like Music up there with me.
Oh, poor Dane. Got stabbed by a nurse spy tuber.
I don't know if that's Dane, though. That doesn't look like Dane.
I don't know whether that's Dane.
Yeah, I'm not sure. But there's a couple of cameos up in here, and, you know, I'm letting the soldier... Look at the soldier putting his shoulder into the back of that payload. And there I am. You know, the job is done. We're just relaxing as we capture the point.
Actually, now that I'm looking at this, this is a payload map, right?
Yeah.
Why is there a capture point?
Why is there a capture point underneath this? What is this? This is crazy. This is Team Fortress 2. Ooh, a nice cartoony one by Flightbot Jetwing. Oh, that's kind of funky. It's got some... Oh, okay, I'm coming out of a disguise cloak. You can faintly see what I was disguised as. Oh, okay, this is very stylized.
Huh.
Do you see all that?
I can barely see the disguise.
Yeah.
Emphasis on barely.
That's cool. I think I'm disguised as the person who is dead there. You can tell they're dead because they've got the X over their eyes and
that little
cartoony death skull coming off of it. So it looks like I'm definitely disguising as them because I can see on my forehead right above my glasses there's that red X that's also just off of their item there. So I'm going for a disguise. I like this. This is really cool. It's really well thought out.
Mm-hmm.
H47 decided to have a play on Meet the Spy, but Meet the Spy is actually me.
Yeah.
But the Heavy and the Soldier is also me and some of my favorite loadout cosmetics. I like that.
I just instantly recognized it from Meet the Spy. By the way, I have been trying to practice with the whole spinning knife trick that the spy does.
Mm-hmm.
It is a rather difficult move to pull off.
Yeah, we've got a little practice ballet song here, and we're starting to practice some of these spy moves together. So, I don't know, maybe we'll survive with all of our fingers intact, who knows.
Yeah.
You know the other thing I didn't notice? I never realized that I never saw the soldier's eyes in this scene because of his helmet is usually over them.
But, oh, yeah.
But with that hat, that expression is kind of like, what?
Just so derpy. Super derp.
Panda Pony has a sketch. I like it. Ooh, that's... See, that's like some of my favorite poses from some of the digital art, too, where the gun's really coming out at you in that forced perspective.
Yeah.
That takes time to do. I really do appreciate how much time all of these take to do. I know I go through a whole lot of them rather quickly, but it does take time and effort, and I appreciate every moment of it. The Ultimate Isaac here has a pose on Cold Front. What do you think about this?
I truly have no idea what's going on, but it looks awesome.
Well, I just like how he's posed the fingers, right? And I like how this is more of... Every now and then I'll get a digital art or a fan art that looks more like a Windows background. You know, it's not exactly got a scene going on behind it. It's just featuring the spy character.
Yeah.
So I like seeing these every now and then. What I might do is I might put them into a folder and sure enough have a rotating background. Just so I come on to something new every day. Avast Indie has this one that I first saw on Twitter, and I saw it made its way onto the digital video log discussion thread. What do you think about this? I'm going to let you have a go at this one.
Everything in this picture is awesome.
Everything is awesome. Everything is cool when you're on my team. I like it. He's even got a stylized ambassador. It's got the etching in it and the trigger's been changed as if it's for a Lego hand. I like this. This is great. I can just see the next Lego movie already. Lego Team Fortress.
Actually, I would I would pay money to buy a full set YouTube Lego Men.
I'd love that. Ben, could you imagine a full TF2 Lego set?
Yeah.
Oh, with all the different YouTubers being their mains, that would be great. Meepo Guy has an unsuspecting strike here. It looks like I see some enemies coming, and I'm ready to throw on a pyro disguise. I've got a smile because I know victory is assured. I already have this all planned out.
Guna Bustin. Looks like you're gonna go for the soldier first, considering that he's a slower fella. Followed up by the spy.
That would be the plan. Let the spy go past. Spy's not really my problem, and once I take out the soldier, exposing the spy in front of my teammates would be the way to go. I like it. I actually wonder if the spy... See, I like that Chicago overcoat that the spy's got on. I've used that with a couple of different loadouts.
Actually, I wonder if that Chicago overcoat thing would go with your unusual hat that you're packing.
Yeah, it does. It goes with the Gnaw. I've actually got a different Gnaw that I wear with it, and I've got a burglar's mask that goes over the top of it. I don't know what it's called, but I need to dye the mask. Oh, I love this one. This one's by table, okay? And we're around a campfire, and I'm telling a story for the children about a time when the phlogistonator got buffed.
Oh, dear.
But what's funny...
I have no idea whether that pyro's terrified or very happy exactly, about that scenario.
Exactly what I was about to say. It's like, you're not sure if the pyro's scared at this, or if he's about to giggle with joy at the buff flog.
Just like he's gonna grab one out of thin air and just go like...
it's like he's seeing the story in pyrovision. But oh, I love what he's done with my fingers on this one too. To really give the expression on the face, the eyes, and the fingers to make it look like I'm telling that spooky camp story type deal.
And another gibbous. At least he bothered to dye his hat pink.
Yeah, it's a dyed gibbous. I dyed my gibbous. Did you dye your gibbous, or did you use your dye on something else?
I think I used my whitish dye on the gibbous.
That's what I'm saying. Who else out there used their first dye that they got with their account and threw it on their gibbous? I want to know. Looks like Sans here has thrown a bunch of YouTubers together as well. I see Dane, I see myself, I see Array, I see Muzelk, all having a go at, looks like a rather inexperienced blue team.
Yeah, just two gibbouses running straight in. Unsure what's happening.
Looks like the sentry gun in a very aggressive position is taking out some more. Oh, I almost didn't notice that. Do you see that dagger? The knife being thrown straight at the camera?
Yeah, it's like you're taking a perspective of one of the noobish blues. Like, barely dodged.
And, look at my pose. I'm looking straight at the camera and I've thrown that knife. I like it. That's classy. Wait, that gibbous spy that I've shot in the head looks like he's laughing at the whole thing. Look at that expression.
But when you're wearing the pyrovision, all deaths sound like they're laughing.
He's probably in pain, but he's laughing. Conquistador Bob has something in a very similar position to the last one. We're on the same Bomb Blitz map. But this time I'm undercover. Like I was saying before, this spy is meant to be me, and I'm undercover with a gibbous.
I'm just observing that pyro, trying to make a clever yet noticeable reference. And I got nothing.
What do you mean, a reference to what?
Just anything involving skulls.
Yeah, I mean, the whole getup is cool. I like how he's got across his bandolier the skulls and the backpack skulls and the face's skulls. It's a very skulled out look, but I'm sure in pyrovision it's all like sunshine and happiness and he's clowning it up.
Or, like in Pymations, Asians meet the amazing pyro, it may be all cotton candy.
Indeed. What in the world is that medic in the background running from? Perhaps we'll never know.
Maybe the spy.
Golden Wolf has this very classy picture. It's even framed. Look at that border and everything. Mr. Paladin, all written out in script. That's classy. That's like a movie poster. That's like a Godfather movie or something.
I have never seen The Godfather, and I'm possibly not allowed to.
You're possibly not. I was about to mention Reservoir Dogs, too, but there's no way you've seen that yet. Very classy. Wearing the rose as well. I wish I could wear that because that's an actual extra miscellaneous item because I'm wearing the hat, the glasses, the suit, so there's no room to add the rose.
Oh, no. Oh, how one must carry the burden of having only 3 hat slots.
Yes, 3 hat slots. How are we ever going to live? How can we play a game with only 3 cosmetic slots? Let's see. How do I pronounce this? Wintersnee? Oh, I'm sorry if I've messed up your name. If you want to get everyone's name, it is in the discussion thread. But we have got just a posed picture where it looks like I'm dusting off my shirt.
Possibly getting rid of that blood or...
Mm-hmm. Possibly some blood on my suit. I'm very happy about it, though.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what went on, I'm not sure what went down. But this is another one of those really good ones that I like the art associated with it, so it's kind of like this would go into that background folder, you know what I'm saying?
Actually, is it even possible to have a rotating background?
Yeah, most operating systems will say, hey, select a folder full of pictures that you'd like to have as your background, and you could set it.
Neat.
Mr. P from Ash. I like the lighting on this one.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure whether the lighting's come from, like, a spotlight for the mine or the letters themselves.
Well, you can see the letters casting the shadow on the wall behind. So it's got to be coming from somewhere in front of the letters. But I like it. Facing down the enemy with grit in my teeth. Well, grit grit in my teeth? No, my teeth showing my grit. You don't really want grit in your teeth. If you got grit in the teeth, go brush and floss right now.
Also, another one of those pictures where the ambassador is kind of pointing out, like,
yep, there, the ambassador's coming at you. And this one here is another one of probably those background type images that I've put in a folder. This one's by Miff. I've called it Shadow just because of the shadow being cast on the wall. Just a nice lighting effect. Nice warm glow.
Whoa, cartoonish.
Yep, this one's a nice cartoon slash art that somebody has done up. From Swordmaster. And yeah, he did this up on his tablet. I like it. Soft glow around. Just the spy being real stylish.
To me, it looks like some expert paper crinkler has crinkled it into the shape of a spy.
Oh yeah, I know. I've seen some of those where they take it and they just keep folding it and folding it until it's in the shape that they want. I wonder if somebody could do that. That's crazy. Dr. Wondertainment had this one called The Passing of the Guard, or like the passing, you know, like the passing of knowledge from one person to another. But if you look here, something sneaky's going on. What do you see in there?
Looks like a double backstab.
Yeah, but it looks like we're both taught each other so well that we're, you know, we're shaking our hands in friendship, but we're prepared for the... for the next play.
Duel.
I'm saying. I kind of like that. That's funny right there. It's like, and we're both smiling, we're both being cordial. It's like, but you know something's about to go down. This is not going to be a confrontation that both people are going to walk away from. Let's see, we got B-Daz or Badaz? Bads? He's actually signed it down the bottom. B-D-A-Z. And this is some artwork called You Got Blood on My Suit.
Huh. Well, if we're taking from the last picture, looks like you walked away from that one.
Yeah, this is the outcome from the last picture. Maybe so. But I like it. I like seeing everyone's different style. We've had a couple of people in this digital art where it's got, you know, the same depiction of a spy, but in each person's different style.
Yeah, like Galego, huge party of tubers, Uber's sketch.
I like this one. Like, check out the jaw of the spy on this one. It's very square and very, very rough. I like it. Much, much tougher look to the spy.
I see.
Marcus did this one. I'm riding the bomb. I'm bringing this in. I've got my dead ringer ready. I'm just showing it to the world. I've taken out the defender who was at the cart, and I'm riding that cart to victory.
from my idea of this, he possibly tried to market Garn you, but fell on the cart.
That would be so fun if I managed to counter a market Garn.
And then you just finished him off with a backstab.
Because of the way market Garns move so fast, though, it's so hard to do a counter stab on that. In fact, I think I saw one time where a spy got blasted up.
Whoa.
And did stab a market gardener out of the air. I have seen that. That's like one of those moments where you, after it happens, you push F6 to see if you can save a replay. Or you see if you're recording or something. Just see if you've saved that moment.
Oh, but then the server does not support recording.
Server does not support replays. It's like nerd.
Why doesn't more servers support replays? I mean, like,
it would be, I don't know. Valve put it in as a feature, and then they turned it off on their own servers. It's so silly. This one's by Unknown, and it's back-to-back, or... You know how we used to do double agents? Got a double agents video?
I don't recall that video. But it looks like one of those three steps, turn around, shoot kind of deals.
I think it's one of these ones where the two spies are respecting each other. Like, we know we're on enemy teams. We don't really mess with each other. There's a job to do. I like it. This one could easily be a thumbnail on a video. This one could also fall into that background folder easily. I might throw some of these up on Facebook and stuff, because some of these are really, really classy. Wave here has one where I'm not even looking at the explosion behind me. This is one of those action movie type
cool
shots.
Cool guys don't look at explosions. Yeah. That's a rule of the universe.
Cool guys do not look at explosions. We cause the explosions and then we walk away and we're like, we know the explosion's happening behind us.
And there's an engineer, just cowering in fear. Like, oh dear. Wait a second. Discrepancy detected. That's a red sentry.
It is a red sentry. What in the world's happened? We've blown up our own sentry? Or is it just covered in blood?
Oh, that would be a twist.
That sentry was a spy.
Oh, actually, that would be something amazing for an April Fool's Day on Valve's part, if you can disguise as a sentry.
You know what? They say in the upcoming, like, spy versus engineer, spy is going to get a different type of disguise, and the engineer is going to get a different type of build PDA, so who knows, maybe we'll be able to disguise it as a dispenser or something like that.
Oh.
Maybe disguise as some prop art or something
great.
Like that.
Great, now I won't be able to trust my own buildings.
Mm-hmm. Is that box really a spy, or is he a box spy, or is a spy a box? Who knows anymore? Evil Cat number 70 had something called this. Well, I called it the Sapper Throw. This is very clearly a stylized two fort basement.
Yeah.
I
think I recall this from like a very earlier version of two fort that you used to play.
I think he actually downloaded a custom version of two fort for this one. But you see, I'm accosting the medic there who's terrified. By the way, if you are holding a gun at someone, don't hold it so close that they could actually grab the gun.
just point it in their general direction.
Yeah, general direction's good, and if they make a move towards you, that's...
Bang!
Mr. Paladin does not endorse you pointing guns at anyone.
Yeah. Just especially loved ones.
Mom, Mr. Paladin's telling me I need to get a gun and point it at people. Dear, maybe I just need to... Let's rewind that. If you ever find yourself in a situation where you're pointing a gun at someone, just don't. Let's just put the gun down and let's converse with each other and resolve the situation.
Unless the situation cannot be resolved.
At which point you have to use the gun.
For instance, a burglary.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, burglary or something like this. Actually, they do teach you a lot, especially in this state. Like, you're allowed to defend your house, but if ever somebody runs from you...
Do not shoot them.
You can't shoot them. You get ed up in court if you did that. But that's enough legal stuff. Saniti. Oh, I'm not sure if I'm... A lot of these names, I'm not sure if I can pronounce them because they've got so many...
Neither can I.
They've got so many, like, verbs. No, not verbs. What am I saying? Not consonants. What's the opposite of consonants?
Vowels.
Thank you. Oh my goodness, I was having a mind trip right there. I couldn't remember what vowels were. Oh, can I buy a vowel, please? Maybe I'm the guy in the Pyrovision in this picture. Maybe I'm not Mr. Paladin at all.
Oh, no, you are Mr. Paladin, because look at the accessories.
Uh-huh, I'm right there.
But there's a friendly Hoovy.
Wait, is there a Hoovy on top of a Hoovy? How is he balancing on that head, or is he jumping down from above? Oh. Man, but isn't that typical? You're playing engineer, you've got a teleporter, you're trying to get things all set up, and your teammates are just goofing it up.
It appears that the NG either has a knife himself, or you have two knives.
He's already been stabbed in the butt or something. What in the world? I didn't even notice that. Marcus has this one. Ooh, this is a playoff of Terminator Genesis. Look at that. That's a stylized poster. Very movie themed. I love the heavy being the Terminator.
Yeah. His skull just kind of fits perfectly with that.
It fits in so gloriously right then. I like that. Movie-esque poster. IDK, so I don't know if that's short for I don't know or I don't care. Or
IDK means I don't know.
I know that means I don't know, but maybe he's I don't care and he's spelling it Mortal Kombat style. Who knows?
Yeah.
But I call this one It Has to Be Done. I mean, that Pyro, he's weak. He's maybe innocent. But he is on the enemy team, and he must be taken out.
Oh, don't do it, Mr. Paladin. Don't do it.
It has to be done.
Oh, no. He was just a gibbous, man. He was just a gibbous.
The gibbous today turns into the pyro monster of tomorrow.
Oh.
This one by Derpy Mario. I love that name. What do you think about Derpy Mario's name?
Kind of sounds like a Nintendo player who would just throw Mario off the ledge using someone else's life. Like, come on, dude. I spent 15 minutes grinding all those lives, and you just go and throw them all away in a ditch.
Derpy Mario sounds like the type of person who would play a Mario level and, like, always die on the first Goomba. And the only enemy on the level is a Goomba. I mean, it's just a Goomba between you and the flagpole. All you have to do is jump it.
How could you mess it up that badly?
Okay, now, with this picture, I'm not sure if we're, like, tapping guns in, like, a salute, as in, like, you know how you clink glasses to toast someone?
Or whether we're
pointing them at each other's head, ready to blow each other's brain out at a moment's notice.
Well then, that's Team Killer Squared, as both of you are red. Seriously, so many pictures depicting...
Well, the best part about dressing in red is you can't tell if there's blood on your suit. Mr. Falcon has this one. I call this one taking the point. Now, I love it when this type of situation happens, but it very, very rarely happens when you're as a spy.
Team 100% wrecked.
Yeah, and you just... I don't know if there's three or four enemies around the point, and somehow everything just magically works on out that you've killed all of them.
Yeah, like, everyone's looking at a single soldier with an air jump, base jumper, like, hey, guys.
Yep, somebody's just flying away from the point. Or I like it best when, like, even your own team doesn't realize what's happened, and, like, it just says, blue team won, and then they're all like, what? What happened? How did this happen?
Actually, you saying that reminded me of my first time playing TF2, where I ran the Red Intelligence from their base to our base as a spy.
As a spy? Oh, that's so difficult to do, because you can't disguise and you can't cloak.
That was just like a single sprint. No dropping, because I didn't know how to drop.
Here's another one of these ones that's good for a background. It's by Reaper, and he's showing my new hat, that new noir that's painted white, and I've got the portal over it.
So many pretty colors.
Mm-hmm. Now, it doesn't have that starry effect that's happening, but the starry effect is working in with that whole the whole color palette going on there with the ambassador and everything. This just looks good. It looks good as a background, just because all of those colors work. I never realized that portal had all the symbols for the different classes in it.
Huh.
Did you notice that? I did not notice that. I hadn't been paying attention. I just thought I was full of cryptic symbols.
Yeah.
Blue Thunder has this one, and it's called My Apologies.
Looks like a crime scene to me.
Oh, it's definitely a crime scene. Look at that police line. Do not cross. I just noticed this. It doesn't look like it's actually Source Filmmaker. It looks like someone's actually painted it or done some sort of post effects on it.
Yeah, it to me, it doesn't have like that noise thing that would be iconic to the Source Filmmaker.
Yeah,
it's just all gone.
It's like somebody used the Source Filmmaker just as a template for another piece of art. I like the style. I like it.
Yeah.
Very stylized. Oh, here's another name I know I'm going to have trouble with. You guys can read it with me there. What is it? S-Doggerman?
I think it's S-Doggerman.
Yeah, that sounds about right. Sorry if I'm mispronouncing any of this, but as you can see, this is what I'm trying to use with. And it looks like I'm posed with him, and we're killing each other's teammates.
Yeah. Also, look at that knife. It's got, like, it's one of its little handles down.
Yeah, I didn't know you could actually pose a knife like that, because, you know, Team Fortress 2 has, like, the player model, which is what you see when you flick open the knife, but it also has that world model that you see when you're looking at another player, and I can't remember if when you're looking at a player and he brings out the knife, if you see him flick it or not.
They just switch instantaneously, like...
Yeah, just kind of switches out. It, like, magically appears in your hand.
Yeah. Also, look at that sniper's arm!
Oh, yeah, he's reaching
like
backward.
To travel.
He's, like, reaching over. Listen, if you get smacked in the back with one of those critical Uber saws, you'd be reaching back for it, too. This next one's by Omega.
Wait, Omega?
Not you, Omega Bot.
Error. 404.
Error 404.
Omega Bot not found.
Art not found. Get it together, man. Reboot. Now, this one's called Go Ahead, and it's very much one of those stylized pictures like, go ahead, make my day.
What number are we at on pictures like these?
I don't know. Six? I've had a few pictures like these, but I always like them. Something about that forced perspective and down the barrel, it looks cool.
Yeah. Oh, now what would be amazing is if there was, like, a texture thingy that you can get for TF2. That actually lets you see down the weapon to see the ammunition at ready.
That would be pretty fun.
But it would lag your game, I would presume.
And this one by Monj, Fight Me Like a Man.
This looks like one of your undercover thumbnail things that you would use.
Yeah, this looks like something where it's just funny. You don't expect Spy to be in like a real world arena like that. Could you imagine Spy trying to be an MMA?
Oh, I'm pretty sure he would get his little French butt.
Well, what about some of the other characters? What about Heavy in MMA?
Oh yeah, with his Tonkyo gun thing.
Yeah, he's there. He's like pow, ha ha. That would actually be hilarious.
I'm actually pretty sure he would go to jail for that, but eh.
You might know this guy, Omega Bot. This is just a blind bot. Do you know any blind robots out there?
No. but I have heard stories of when that got his photon sensor blown out by an explosive.
Yep.
Just like overheated, boom, straight out of there.
Well, it's okay. Anything's replaceable. It's time for an upgrade when that happens.
Yeah. Get one of those like X-ray detecting ones. Let you see through walls.
Ooh, Wallbot.
Oh my.
Actually, are you friends with the aimbots and warbots that I don't know about?
No, please
you
don't back me.
Cheating scumbag.
Don't back me.
And that's kind of the expression I'm looking at here on Two Fort. I'm just looking almost with disgust at the camera.
Yeah, like it just killed a hacker of sorts. Actually, yeah, well, speaking of hackers, have you heard the news about the Valvac wave? Completely destroying the Lamo box?
Yeah, I mean, that's just gone around. That's been a good day. You know, there's still going to be cheaters around because TF2 is free to play, so they'll, like, create a free-to-play account and just download the free cheat and stuff like that and have a go for a little while, but at least it'll get them out of matchmaking and some of the other things that are coming out.
Phew.
The Drugged Squirrel has this one. Looks like I'm planning the next course. This is another one where it looks like I'm planning a few stages ahead. It's like I've taken care of the pyro, now I'm looking on to the next thing.
Once more, another picture where I see myself as the victim.
You see yourself as the victim rather than the spy? Yeah. What, are you a pyromane now? Is there something I need to know? Last I checked in, you were an engymane.
But you're just that good. I don't see myself as the spy. I see myself as the victim.
Okay.
You always pull off the trick stabs.
I mess them up quite a bit. But of course, you know, I'm not going to upload a montage of failed trick stabs. I mean, yeah. Sheesh. No one wants to see that. Bernard Fish has this one. I called it NG Down.
Huh. Looks like the engineer wasn't killed by your hand. Looks like someone behind the wall.
Well, I don't know. I might have given him a shot. That is a Diamondback, after all. It might have been a critical hit.
Sentry's still up, though.
Yep, Sentry's still up, and its barrels are spun up. It's ready to go, so I've got to think about this.
I've never noticed how weird the Sentry's spun-up barrels look.
The spun-up barrels look awesome.
Yeah, but to me, they just look like a huge cylinder that's carved.
No, it looks like two really huge barrels, like two loose cannons. That's what we need to do. We need to have a mod for the Sentry gun that has two loose cannons on it. Boom, boom.
Oh. Actually, wouldn't it be awesome if, like, the next PDA for the engineer is, like, a Sentry gun that shoots pills like the Demo Man? Like,
shoots Demo Man pills and just lobs them over? Sheesh. I don't know. You kind of need the accuracy out of the Sentry gun. Duo Requin has this one. It looks straight up like a thumbnail. Again, I'm wearing the four miscellaneous items.
I'm pretty sure he intends it to be a thumbnail.
Yes, it's done thumbnail style. But I'm wearing those four miscellaneous items. I wish I could wear the rose.
Yeah, that's something. Valve, go ahead and make something so you can fuse hats and items together.
I don't know if you want that. There's already a loadout, even with the three miscellaneous items, where Sniper can wear, like, 7 or 8 sunglasses. Because he has the one on by default, and then there's some hats with extra glasses, and it's just too many. This next one is nice. This is by Eerie. It doesn't even have me in it at all, which is cool. I just like the Source Filmmaker art. And it's just called They're Coming.
Oh my.
And it looks like Scout's making some moves on Femme Scout. Mm-hmm. Out on a date. And next thing you know, interrupted by aliens. Come down, abduct you.
Of course. Aliens always need to show up with future loving couples.
It's like, we're young and we're in love. Time for some aliens. Huntsworth has this one called Spy Teamwork. It looks like I'm just standing back and enjoying the show. But I guarantee you that jag, so you see swinging there, is going to be a critical.
Of course.
It's got to be.
Jag always crits.
It always crits.
Oh, from the picture, it looks like you headshot the scout just like, boom.
Yeah,
now
maybe.
He's flying in the
air. Maybe he was jumping over and I just popped the headshot.
Wait a second.
Helping the spy out.
Wait a second. This is Badwire, isn't it?
No, this is Upward.
Upward, sorry.
Mm-hmm.
It's a payload map, right? Discrepancy detected. The point is actually missing.
The capture point is missing? Well, that's what happens sometimes with the Source Filmmaker. Sometimes the models aren't there, right? And we have this one by Red, and he says it's Spiky Mikey who's in there, so maybe that's a YouTuber or somebody he knows that is up in there, and we're working. I don't know, are we working together? It looks like I've just stabbed the pocket that medic had, that's for sure.
Yeah. It's not quite. Now, with pictures like these, I have no idea whether the red or whatever opposite color you are is just blissfully ignorant of what just happened, or they're teaming with you.
No, I think he's aware of what happened. I think, instead of stabbing the medic, I had to have a go at his pocket, and he's now chasing me with his Blutsauger.
Well then, one question. Why doesn't he just shoot?
I think he is shooting. It's just you can't. Sometimes you don't have all the action in there. Use your imagination. Imagination.
I am a robot. Imagination.
Robot
does
not compute. Of course. I knew you were going to talk about not computing. Speaking of robots and computing, we've got this one from Ninja Pandas.
Oh my.
Or Ninja Panda.
Wait,
And it's, I love it. It's a forced perspective because he's got that letterbox effect, so you can tell that the robot is close to you.
Yeah.
And that I'm just further away and looking
actually,
up.
Actually, is that a sniper bot or a spy bot or what?
I don't know. He's got a sniper rifle, but he looks like he could be a spy bot.
Yeah. Maybe it's both. Maybe it's a sniper spy bot, like goes cloak and then travels behind enemy lines.
You know what?
Like...
That would be scary in the next MVM if they had some hybrid bots.
Oh my.
Goodness gracious.
Oh, just imagine a pyro spy. Spy robot.
It's like, you know, the... What about some of the fist heavies or something in MVM being able to build teleporters or something
no.
like that?
That would be my nightmare.
Could be gnarly. And this one's by Tracer. It's called Team Up. Or I've called it Team Up. I don't know. Sometimes teaming up with a pyro, the craziest things can happen. And I think this pyro is on the little side of crazy.
Yeah.
And I'm just going with it. Let's just go with it. Sure, you wanna team up where I'm on your shoulders? Let's give it a go.
I'm pretty sure in a spy pyro bro pair, air the pyro would just like freak them out, make them turn to pyro. Spy comes in for the stab, like.
Mhm. That's what I'd usually like to do. Timo wants to do a video sometime soon of a spy and a pyro teaming up. I'll have to touch base with him again on that one.
That sounds cool to watch.
Because, you know, pyros get your attention, and if you don't have their attention, they're going to burn you and get your attention. Koala has this one posed on Bomb Blitz. I'm just looking menacing there. What do you think about that one?
Definitely menacing. No clue what's going on.
Well, there's no clue. It's just one of those ones that would make it into the background folder.
Yeah. Actually... kind of looking at us like, hey, you want to know how far this knife can go down your back?
It's
all
like...
the way.
I don't know if you heard that. He said, you want to know how far this knife can go down your back? All the way. Oh, some akimbo action here by Nebula.
Oh, I can just imagine this in live action, like, bang, 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 bang,
mm-hmm.
bang, bang.
It reminds me of, like, a John Woo film or something, where you've got a gun in each hand, you're diving through a doorway, pow, 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 pow.
Bang, 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 bang.
But I'm killing teammates again. What is this with me and killing teammates?
Maybe you just got mad with power and started
got mad
doing
with power.
Genocide.
I must kill everybody.
No one left alive.
Let's see, Warm here, talking about trick shots. My goodness, Warm here with a trick shot. Doing a backflip. Taking aim, looking down the barrel, aiming for that headshot, and it looks like it's going to be on the money, too.
Yeah. Actually, wait a second. The sniper has his surrender animation. That means Red Team won. Why? I'll just take it that it's a Source Filmmaker error.
No, well, I think it's a Source Filmmaker plot device, okay? It's like he's already trembling in fear at what's about to happen, and
he just like knows he can't get out of the way. He's all like, oh, no.
Exactly.
And that's a slightly good sniper with the hats provided. Or,
well, you know,
goggle.
Just like everyone else, miscellaneous items does not determine your skill level. I think the artist of this one did apologize. He's saying he didn't mean for the unusual effect on my hat to still be in my face. I don't.
Just imagine the first person view is just like a giant cloud there.
That just increases the difficulty level just a little bit on the shot when I've got rain in my eyes.
But wait, aren't you wearing those glasses though? You're kind of rain protected.
Mm-hmm, the glasses might be saving me. Mange has this one here, and again, I'm posed. This looks like a really good one just for a background.
Yeah, looks like it will definitely fall in the background
mm-hmm.
file.
Just the lighting effect, showing off the etching on the ambassador. You know, classy spy stuff.
Looks like it just walked away from the point like a boss, like, yeah, a single.
But I'm on defense. I'm red again. I'm red again on defense. So what, am I approaching the point?
You know some of the capture point maps. It's like
mm-hmm.
they're always trading off hands.
Yep. They keep swapping back and forth, but not this one. That one doesn't. This one by Mighty Matt. named Don't Mess With Me. Just got that Don't Mess With Me look on it.
Why would I mess with Mr. Paladin? Pretty sure I would die. 2.5 seconds flat.
Well, I die sometimes. People seem to have this notion that I never die or something. I mean, I do well, but goodness gracious, I get served sometimes.
Please remember my current skill level as any class for that game.
Okay. So, like in a me versus you showdown.
Yeah.
Well, we gotta practice you up. We gotta do that zero to hero stuff again.
I'm thinking like some MVM.
Oh, and some MVM. You're enjoying that? We'll have to jump in some MVM games.
I've been playing some of the Two City maps.
Two City? Yeah, I think Thalas would like to jump on that.
Yeah.
That'd be fun. Whoa, I don't know if I can spell this one. He's got it signed down the bottom with that highlighted A, but this was, what, jokes? And this is on Barn Blitz. It looks like I'm assessing the situation. Whoa. Trying to decide what do I do. Do I take out the teleporter first before trying to jump on the medic and heavy, or do I get the heavy just so he's off the cart while the pyro is not looking? What do I do?
Okay, how I would go about doing this. Wait for the medic to pocket the heavy, take out medic, then follow it up with the heavy, take out that pyro, arrow, get the engineer, sap the teleporter, and then go for the gibbous sniper.
And you know it's a gibbous sniper because he's heading to the front line. What is that sniper doing? Just sit at the back behind your heavy medic. What kind of sniper? What? Is his aim that bad? He needs to put the sniper barrel right up against the person's head to get a headshot?
Just
what?
A point blank shot, like...
Reminds me of that sniper! Reminds me of that other thumbnail that we have one time where I have the sniper, like, looking down like the barrel of his own gun. Silly.
I know that one.
TC did one here, and it's one of these versus Dane shots, so it looks like I'm surprising Dane here.
Oh, this just gives me that Slenderman vibe, you know?
Oh, it does? Like, creepy?
It's like in the deep forest, or some person that can walk
around.
Yeah,
he is holding a lantern, isn't he?
Yeah, just like slowly turning about, like... Is he behind me?
Like, surprise.
Ah!
One of those creepypastas or something like that.
Yeah.
Speaking of creepypastas, let's have a look at this. This looks almost like it's Fallout 4 or something. Your worst nightmare made this one, and it's called Zombie.
Oh. This is like a horrible rendition of Frankenstein.
It's like Frankenstein. Well, is he trying to bring me alive? Is he trying to cure me? I'm not sure. This is a mix of some crazy technology going on.
No matter what, you're kind of in some... He's kind of in some horrible conditions if you're a zombie and he's trying to strap you down.
Yeah, I think I'm waking up and I'm going to be coming at him. I think that's the look on his face.
Just like the hunter from Left 4 Dead's lunge, like...
Oh, dear. Here's another one of these defenses at Barn Blitz. This almost looks like it's a little bit further on from the last scene we had.
Except with more hats.
The more hats this time?
More hats.
Definitely. But yeah, it looks like we've got the defensive locker
room.
Looks
like the scout, soldier, and pyro are going to die soon.
Well, what about that red sniper? He's got a lot of nerve to be staring down his barrel in front of a sentry gun. Good night.
Oh...
I better go help these guys. They're gonna need my help.
Yeah. Once again, I would just like... Oh, no smoking.
Yep, Catton here with a no smoking pitcher, and it's like, I'm spy. I don't need your laws.
Yeah. No. Just dumb idea. I'm like imagining a spy in a real life setting. How many laws would he break?
I'm pretty sure murdering people is against the law.
I know that! That's why I was thinking it was a stupid question!
What do you mean, like, jaywalking? Is Spy a jaywalker? Would Spy litter? Is he a litter bug?
Well, considering that he just flicks his cigarette.
He flicks a cigarette off all the time. Guess so. It's like, sir, do you know how many cigarette butts you've thrown away?
All of them.
This one's signed by Beta, or Beta, depending on what part of the world you come from. And this is just a King of the Hill scene, looking classy.
Successfully sapped a sentry, possibly killed the engineer so it won't come back.
That sounds like a tongue twister. Successfully sapped a century.
Successfully sapped a century.
Successfully sapped a century.
Huh. And you're just staring down the
sea
moon.
Spy successfully sapped a century.
I actually wonder, did we just spawn a tongue twister from that?
Maybe. Let's see if you guys can say it at home. We've got DJ underscore here with a dead ringer scene. Let's see.
Kind of looks like moments after the previous scene.
Could be. Could be. Am I sitting on top of a lamp? What's happening here?
You're either standing on thin air or sitting on a lamp. Both scenes would be silly. Wait.
It's kind of a strange perspective, isn't it?
Wait. Discrepancy detected once more. That is the wrong unusual effect.
Yeah, that's not an unusual effect I've got, but still, like, I'll let it pass. I mean, I've got a couple of hats with a couple of different unusual effects. It's all right.
Yeah.
Let's see. We've got pyros going around. I like that spy in the background looking for a high five.
It's not my hand.
It looks like a bunch of the red team is just chilling out. I mean, we got soldiers.
Well, except for that pyro that's about to go nuts
on that soldier. Yeah, he's about to burn that soldier's butt, that's for sure. Let's see, we have Holy Cat PL with us just chilling. I never noticed how big those bottles are. That is a lot of beer.
No wonder why Demoman's always drunk. One bottle and then just completely hammered for the rest of the game.
Indeed. And it looks like we're done. We're just going to let him cap. I don't know what's happened, but these spies have just had enough of defense. Maybe our team has just really let us down and we're just like, fine, just cap it.
Oh, and that scout. That is the vengeful scout that's all like, you killed me 5 times in the last 5 minutes. Prepare to pay!
I like it how he's holding the gun all gangster style sideways.
Yeah. Oh, wait. That pyro may see the feet.
The pyro, I don't know, he might have pyro vision on it. It might look like bananas or something. Who knows? Hopefully he won't.
Or maybe not at all, because pyro vision's view of the characters are like,
babies. Yeah, so then you wouldn't see our feet if he's in pyro vision, because our little baby feet wouldn't be dangling over enough.
Yeah, but maybe he'll hear the chuckle.
Kylo Ren with this Star Wars depiction. Oh, it's a mix of a sci-fi depiction. So we've got the bat sabers, and he's having a go at Alien Scout. He's killing him down. We need to pick up some lightsabers and have a lightsaber battle.
Oh.
You and me.
Oh dear.
Yeah, that's what
just
I need.
Just like have a lightsaber.
I should totally get that full get up like Luke Skywalker at the end of the recent Force Unleashed. Wait, no, Force Unleashed, Force Awakened. I'm thinking about Force Unleashed, the game. The Force Awakens. Nyan Zach has this one. I'm calling this one not a medic. It looks like I was disguised as that medic, but then I've surprised the demo man with a backstab, and I'm giving a thumbs up, and I've just got... It looks like I've got my entire loadout on me. I've got every type of sapper and every type of gun going on.
Every type of knife. Every type...
I am everywhere. Everything. I am everyone.
Actually... I wonder if that snack attack's gonna snack on Wheatley.
Maybe. Wheatley would have something to say about it, that's for sure.
That'll teach him for taking over Aperture.
Mm-hmm. I heard a funny thing recently that the reason the space module is orbiting Wheatley
space
is because...
Core.
Yeah, it's because Wheatley is so dense. So he has a higher gravitational pull. Rogue Assassin here. With I'm calling this smug. It's like a job well done. I've stabbed the sniper.
Headshot the soldier.
Headshot the soldier. I'm in a rather safe spot, so I'm just relishing in the moment.
Oh.
Got that little smile going on.
And it looks to be a pretty red death too. I mean, look at that blood splatter. It's everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Better get the forensic team in on that blood splatter to see what caused it.
Actually, with all that blood. It's amazing how none of it got on your suit.
Could you imagine the bad CSI team saying, well, it's obvious that the sniper headshot the soldier, and then the soldier retaliated by throwing his knife at the back of the sniper. Case closed. Case closed. Obvious suicide. Shockwave here with a conga. Looks like I'm dancing it out with conga, conga, stab, with the other soldiers
conga,
here.
Conga stab.
Conga, conga stab. Actually, that would actually fit. I wish during the conga, the spy would actually stab the people as he's waving his arms around.
Would you look at that? Another thing that I see wrong.
What's that?
The spy is doing the conga taunt whilst the sky...
Well, that's half the fun of it. You've got to let go on some of these technicalities, man.
I'm sorry.
You get too serious in these Source filmmakers, man, ripping them up. Here's another one, a good one for a background folder. Samui, I could be saying that wrong. With coffee, I'm just chilling. It looks like a glorious moment.
Yeah. It looks like a crimson moon is rising up.
Mm-hmm. Blood moon.
Usually in Terraria, that would mean that you have to fight a whole bunch of monsters.
Oh, dear.
Whole bunch. Ah. So annoying.
I haven't played much Terraria. I land my mine has this one called Teleporter Trust. Do we trust what's at the other end of this teleporter? I don't know if we trust it. Do you trust it? I don't look like I'm trusting that at all. Look at that, hands on the hips. I'm looking like frustrated, like, engineer, I can't believe you just sent me there.
Either that or that's an exit and you're just like waiting for it to spin up and it's like, is there going to be a spy or a normal player?
Mm-hmm, maybe so. Maybe I was being chased at the time by a spy. Have you ever had that? Have you ever made a spy trust you into a teleporter? I've had it happen. I've had crazy... Actually, my best things with the teleporter is when I'm fighting people and I either sapped the teleporter and the sapper got removed or I just left the teleporter there. And when things went bad, I just rode the teleporter out of there. I just like nope out. I go to the exit. Then I sap and destroy it so they can't follow me.
Possibly my favorite things is when you're making a teleporter. You're standing on it whilst a spy is sapping it.
Mm-hmm.
And then you just telefrag him.
Like, yep, telefragging him. So much fun. I'm Beast has this one. I'm calling it Trespassers because trespassers will be violated. And that guy obviously was not permitted in there. Knife in the chest. Wait, sapped.
Knife in chest, yep, there's or a knife in throat?
Oh, probably knife in throat. There's a lot of blood. It might be throat.
Yeah.
And we're just taking a moment as spies do in their spy ways. I like that one. I like ones that seem to tell a story with it, and that one tells a story.
Yeah, it looks like he tried to do a special throw knife trick.
Mm-hmm.
And got him straight in the neck whilst they returned to their sentry to try and build it up. Then you just went under a cloak, sapped it, and then relished the moment.
Mm-hmm. Well, thanks for watching. I hope this helps you in your future endeavors. Be sure and send me in Source Filmmaker art and other art. As you saw, we had a bunch of different art here. I love the stuff that people actually do up and then send a digital version. Or if you want to send me a letter in the description of the video, I have my P.O. box, so you can send that in, and we'll be doing that vlog as well. So thanks for coming along, OmegaBot. It was fun to have you here.
No problem. And also, one more thing. I have never noticed how the light was shining so beautifully.
Oh, yes. That is a beautiful, beautiful light.
Oh.